Good viewers, and welcome here to the Hazy Crawford Stadium in Port of Spain. We'll join you just about 10 minutes going here in the first half action between Naughty Stars and St. Anne's Rangers. Not even Naughty Stars, sorry. They say an infringement they're being called. I'm just able to see clearance being made there. Coach Jabalte in there. Black and green. Jabalte scoring here. And a stroke of the 11th minute. So that's 1-0 already, Samuel Jabalte. Couldn't quite make out the goal scorer there. So on center field. Climbing in the back, infringing opportunity here now. Smith. No, it's McPhee. Taking a shot, one low hard, and goal, ricocheting off the body of the defender there. But it's in the back of the net, so just as quickly we see an equalizing goal here. Nice little play on that free kick. Goalkeeper had no chance there to save that one, so it's 1-1 here at the Hazy Crawford Stadium. And just as quickly as St. Anne's Rangers gave up a goal, they got one right back on that free kick opportunity. 1-1, ladies and gentlemen.
They have recently brought in Kerry Batiste. What an awful mix up there.
And it's going to be just
a little bit too wide.
Here's Grosvenor.
Just want to say, Aaron, thanks to our helper, Zane. Brought
and you see, George, as we spoke of that, quickly McPhee coming there and scoring his second goal of the game. The complete breakdown in defense there for Samuel Jabalte. So after scoring first, and by a large margin too, George. I don't think it's just, you see, unless they're developing here. And it's going to be goal number. Nice save, but unfortunately, McPhee will get number three.
And it's
31 minutes gone, George, and three goals already for McPhee. Are we possibly going to be seeing a seven goal?
Well, is it that?
You see a strong header coming in there, unfortunately. Giving up those three goals that we see now. St. Anne's Rangers threatening once more. Shot coming in possibly. No, it's not. Yes, it is. And it's going to be goal number four, is it? No. Infringement they're being called. So, saved by the whistle there. St. Anne's Rangers making things happen upfield. We see another opportunity here. This one could be goal number. No, it's not. Not getting that left-footed shot on target there.
It's going to give Rangers some confidence here. You know, a win, an opportunity,
and it's goal number four.
And it's so easy, and we see the Kevin Jones familiar for a flip by, and that's actually the end of the first half. Four goals to one in favor of St. Anne's Rangers. McPhee, the skipper for Rangers, with his hat-trick. And Isles with the fourth item. And the lone goal for the Jabalte team is from the boot of their skipper, Kerry Batiste. Welcome back, viewers. You are just in time to see the kickoff of the second half here from the Hazy Crawford Stadium. Samuel Jabalte.
And just that is taking place. Jabalte really need to hold that defense together. I don't think I've seen any changes. We've seen now a possible opportunity here. Goal number two for Kerry Batiste. Yes, it is. Kerry Batiste finishing quite effectively. And now we're here, the supporters from Samuel coming up and cheering Kerry Batiste there. Goal number two.
This is a good opportunity here.
Not giving.
And it's going to be a free kick in a very... Well, it all depends on the player who's going to take that free kick, but it's in a good position. Well,
shot coming in. Good
save there. That ball was heading straight into the net there, but good goalkeeping there. But a good free kick nevertheless.
He's trying to get it past him. Here's Grosvenor. Grosvenor goes back.
Shot coming in there again, but not on target. But what we're seeing here, Aaron, is that the Rangers has taken back that advantage they had over Jabalte in the last couple of minutes.
Much like the first half.
They kept a lot of ball possession, but they have lost it here in the last couple of minutes, and Jablote has regained, you know, the sort of, and the ball comes in again, and that's about the third shot coming in there from the Rangers team.
Get that type of comfort you would have liked with the ball at his feet, still getting it back now. Here's Kerbatis. Kerbatis looking for Reni Brito. Shot coming in right where Reni Brito. Goal number three. Reni Brito. Goal number three. And I said it, George. I said it. If St. Anne's can score four in the first half, why can't San Juan?
Well, it's now 4-3. And more, Iran. This game is starting to remind me of the Tiantek Jablote game.
We're seeing Jablote as
and what did I say? This Jablote team is a team that can do magic. And is it a repeat of Tiantek versus Jablote?
Well, George, there's still quite a lot of time. 20 plus minutes left in this one if you count the added on time. So it's going to be quite interesting. Nice of the control, complete breakdown there by the defense of St. Anne's Rangers. And goal number four, hat-trick for Kerry Batiste.
But it was a well-taken goal there, Aaron. And I said before, if McPhee could score a hat-trick for Rangers, why can't Kerry Batiste do the same?
Getting in control, yes he does. Sends it across the goal. This could be an interesting headed on there. And it's going to be saved. Good save there by Marciano. He was going in the wrong direction. He had to make up about 10 or so feet. Did very well in getting there and saving that one. And it's going to be going the other way. Nicely controlled there by James, but losing control of his feet. And this could be interesting. This could be interesting. This could be shot here for Reni Brito. Yes, it is. And it's going to go.
Oh,
George! What did I say, George?
Jablote has performed what we consider is it a miracle.
Well, I actually call
it's
it a
comeback of the season.
He was really active in the first half, but he's not been able to do anything. And here's Reni Brito. Will he be looking for threes? Looking across here. Is it finding Kerry Batiste? Kerry Batiste has one on him. Smith there, and Smith infringing. So an opportunity in a good position here for San Juan Jablote. Surprisingly enough, a tale of two halves. Hospedales, he's taking a shot. And goal number six. Just like that. I thought it could have been four, but goal number six. 6-4 in the last two games. St. Anne's Rangers have allowed 13 goals. Goal number six. And Clark really, really is having a tough start to this 2013 season.
And six in the second match. Are they going to be getting 14?
Speaking of the Rangers coach, I wonder what his plan of attack or defense was, as we see.
14 goals.
This is amazing.
This is an amazing comeback here. I mean, the supporters who are here cannot understand or even try to imagine what is happening here. His son is on the national team. But and it's an opportunity here to pull one back, is it?
Peters, goal number five.
And it's goal number five for Rangers.
After being very active in this one, goal number five.
Yes, as I was saying, I know his son is on the national team. His coaching abilities, I am not too sure of it. But
down in the corner there, I think it's going to be just a matter of time until we hear the final whistle in this one.
We should be hearing the whistle anytime, because this game definitely didn't have much. And what an awful. And that's the end of this game here. Congratulations must go out to San Juan Jablote. Coming back from the dead, actually, where they were massacred actually in the first half. Trailing by 4 goals and coming back here in the second half to win this game by 6-5.